He is the most photographed man on Wall Street, working on the floor of the Stock Exchange for over 35 years now. Peter Tuchman, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So you know a thing or two about how stocks work here.
I do. Okay. I actually do.
So I want to get your sentiment now. We're speaking ahead of the Fed,
right. And
there is talk that they may be cutting for the first time since 08. What's the sentiment like here on the floor?
So look, I'm not, you know, it's a fascinating thing. It's sort of counterintuitive for me. I mean, if you look at it historically, we have markets trading at record highs.
Right.
The market does not really need a stimulus, it seems. The Fed changes are basically economic data related changes, right? I mean, and normally it goes concurrent with a weakness in the market or a rally in the market. As you've said, since 08, we've seen nothing but raises. And the market is trading at record highs. Does it need a stimulus now? So basically, data is not economic data that's coming out to us right now. Doesn't seem like it should be pointing in that direction. It seems for the first time in many, many years, it's a decision being based on forward-looking sentiment.
Now, stocks are trading cautiously today ahead of the Fed. So are you surprised by that? And then it'll go back to normal post that?
I don't look at this as cautious trading. So the market is at 27,260. The S&P is above 3,000. These are big levels, right? We've been able to support these levels for the last couple of weeks with whatever anxiety there is about the Fed, about earnings, and whatever headwinds we're looking at relative to trade, China, and whatnot. Go ahead. You were
going to say something. So which brings me to that next point, IPOs, hottest trades of the year, doubling the market here, which I need to ask you, how much more juice is left? You're talking about, you know, how frothy it is.
Okay, so let's there are two separate things. There's IPO fever and there's the markets. Okay, the way that stocks come to the stock exchange, the price discovery process, the fact that they're being offered up to the public, sometimes doesn't have that much to do with how the market is doing. Eventually, see, a lot of people are trading these IPOs. Those are not long-term investors. So I think where the market is, it's obviously helpful to have a nice, strong, firm market when an IPO is launched. But at the end of the day, I think they stand on their own with IPO fever. I call it that way. Look at what we've seen.
Right.
We had a great 14 and 15. 2014 and 15 were great for IPOs. Then we had a couple of years where it was either lack of interest, they didn't perform well or whatnot. Then we had that short sort of spell at the end of last year with the government shutdown where there are no IPOs, right? Now we've had this year, they've been hot. There has been a fever. You can look at the NASDAQ ones, like the Beyond Meats and whatnot, and then you can see the ones we've seen here that have acted well, performed well, and look sort of, and these are companies that are not making money yet. So I'm not worried that we're gonna run out of steam on this one for this year, as far as the interest in IPOs. People are looking for, look, if you are questioning whether to buy the market at these high valuations,
right. Maybe
you wanna put your interest into the IPOs. So it's another instrument for people to play with.
Well, people are comparing, you mentioned Beyond Meat, you know, up 700% since its IPO. There's comparisons to things such as Bitcoin when we're looking at the volatility. Is that a just comparison?
I think that Beyond Meat is a little out of my wheelhouse. It's a NASDAQ stock, it's a sector I don't look at that much. I kind of think it's a bubble, I think it's a little bit strange. I think it's definitely been fueled a lot with that fever. We saw it with a lot of the cannabis stocks too, that they really rallied up like crazy and then came in big. We saw them, there was one of the big cannabis names that just went off the rails. So I don't want to address that much, but we saw it with Uber. Uber had a nice rally, then came back in, even though Lyft did not perform well at all. The IPOs we've seen here in the last couple of months have actually acted well. I think it's just fascinating. For a market, the Dow is up 60, the S&P's holding these levels. I don't think this is cautionary trading. I think this is kind of consolidation and pause, wait and see. I'm fascinated by what, you know, normally the days that they actually lower or raise interest rates are great, fun, exciting, super volatile days. Whether it's a prolonged situation, I'm not sure. Everybody is saying that a 25-point basis point cut here is already priced into the market. So are they going to do 50 points? Probably not. Are they going to do 50 points by September meeting? Probably. How is the market going to react here, right? We do have some last week. They're trying to give us a narrative to explain why they're lowering rates at a market that is at its highs. Slow down in manufacturing, slow down in business investment, you know, headwinds with the trade talks with China kind of stalling. These are forward-looking potential problems that give them the excuse to lower rates at a time where it seems counterintuitive.
All right, Peter, finally to wrap here, give us some sectors you're eyeing. What do you like?
You know what? I don't look at individual sectors or stocks. I like to analyze the market on a day-to-day basis. I love to look at headlines, see what makes the market move. I think it's a fascinating time. I really look forward to Wednesday's cut, okay, just to see how the market acts. Intraday movement, the way stocks open and the way they close is what fascinates me.
Peter, 35 years, never a dull day. Is that safe to say?
Never a dull day.
Never know what you're going
to
get.
Just remember, if you find something you love to do, you'll never work a day in your life.
You know what? I count myself as one of those lucky few.
Awesome.
Peter, most photographed man.
Einstein of Wall Street.
It's a true honor for me to interview you today.
Me
thank
too.
You so much. Thank you, Peter.
Awesome. Thank you.
Fine.